in the new world, eternally. And we don't have to worry about the things in this world. Peace. Peace gives that to me. If you want peace, internalize peace in your mind. Internalize happiness. Internalize joy. Don't let the enemy take your peace. The enemy takes your peace by messing with your mind. That's why they're talking. Because they're trying to get to your mind. But you gotta block that. Block it from reality. You know who you are. You are children of God. And he gives us peace. And that is all you need to keep your mind on him to get that peace. Trust in God for that peace. Don't worry about stuff that's going on in this world. I served in the U.S. Army 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I don't know how many hours they equal to, and I don't know how many minutes they equal to. You can rest assured, I serve my country as I serve God, because I love my country, and I love my family and my friends, and I want them to have the freedom that someone gave to me before me. Not one night have I ever, and I've been in the military 25 years, not one night have I ever, or will I ever, be concerned about the leadership of this country. Ever. Because it is not up to the leadership to decide my fate with God. And if I want peace in my mind, I'm not going to see CNN, whatever those other news stations are, mess with my mind and tell me about what everybody's doing up there or who they selected for this and for selected for that. I don't care about that. All I care about is me doing my job and upholding the duties and the responsibilities of this country. And that gives me all the peace I need to keep on serving. We've got to stop worrying about stuff that keeps messing with our mind. Everything we see in the news. We got to stop reading. Some of us, the only reading, the only word we get are devotionals from Facebook, devotionals from text messages. Go get your own words so you can have some peace for yourself. There's nothing wrong with reading that. Don't get me wrong, because I do it. I send out text messages. I do it all the time. But that's the reason why I send you those scriptures. For you to read it for yourself. Read the word for yourself. Because that's what gives you peace. And when you get that peace, you won't worry about that stuff. I'm not worried about anything. If I was going to worry about that, I would have been worried a long time ago. Before that. That can't destroy this world any more than anyone else could have who has ever been anywhere in this country. It's up to us as Christians to get our mind right. So that we can bring more people into the body of Christ. That's our job. Our job is not to worry about anything else outside of the body of Christ. Our job is to serve God by going out and pulling more people in to the body of Christ. Bringing more people into this church so that they can be saved. We want to get as many people into the new world. I got some family members that I will miss when I go to the new world. I will miss them. And I'm talking to them and I'm ministering to them as much as I can. But they only own. They're only on when that day comes. But while I'm here, I will continue to be persistent and work hard to bring them into that body of Christ so that they can experience a new world as I have. A lot of people can't even visualize the new world because they don't have peace in their mind. You can't tell people about the new world because your mind is not in the new world. Your mind is in the world as it is now. Internalize in your mind.
All right.
Jesus.
Jesus.
That is the best five-letter word. If you can't internalize anything else, just focus your mind. Force your mind. With force, make your mind Say, Jesus.
All right.
Keep your mind focused on peace.
Yeah.
Then you'll have peace. Amen?
Amen.